Hello friends, today we just revise the tenses. So first mainly I just discuss about the tense. How many tenses are there? There are 12 tenses are there: present tense, past tense, future tense. Present tense has 4 tenses: simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, and present perfect continuous tense. Past tense has also 4 tense, and future tense has also 4 tense. So there are 12 tenses are there, but first we get knowledge about present tense, and the first present tense is the simple present tense. Simple present tense, it is used in habitual action. You know the habitual action, the action what we perform, what we do daily. So that action can be described, that action can be described by using simple present tense. Example, I get up early in the morning. So it is our habitual action. It is also used to say about our routine work. I go to school at 7:30 a.m. So that routine work can be also expressed by using the simple present tense. It is also used for the general truth. General truth, like 2 and 2 make 4. Honey is sweet. So all this type of the general truth can be expressed by simple present tense. Universal truth, like the sun rises in the east, the earth revolves around the sun. So this universal truth can be expressed by the simple present tense. Proverbs, experience is the best teacher. Saying sentences, whatever the sentences had delivered by someone before many years, but when they are represented, they are said in its real form. Like Shakespeare said, life is a drama. So he had delivered this sentence before 300 years. But now today, it is described in its as it is form. So we can say life is drama, not life was drama. We can say so. Same sentence is described by using the simple present tense. Live program, like a cricket commentary, live program. So all this event can be expressed by the simple present tense. Fixed future, suppose the school will be open on 15th June. So we can say like this, the school opens on 15th June because it's a fixed future. Current events, today what we are facing the problem, what the situation we are facing. So this current event can be also described by using the simple present tense. For example, temperature increases day by day. So temperature increases day by day. So in all this type of the sentence, in all the situation, we can use simple present tense. First, now we discuss about the structure of the simple present tense. The first structure: subject, first form of the verb, and object. But when we follow this structure, when as a pronoun, I, we, you, and they, this subjective pronoun come in the sentence, we have to follow this structure: subject, first form of the verb, and object. For example, we play game, I play game, you play game, and they play game. Or plural noun comes. When the plural noun comes, so in this, we also have to follow this structure: subject, first form of the verb, and object. Like people. People believe in God. So people believe in God. We have to write believe in God, not believes in God. It's wrong because we have to follow the first structure. The second structure: subject plus s and es is added with the verb and object. But when it comes When as a pronoun, he, she, it comes a third person singular or singular noun. For example, she sings well, he works in office, it flies faster. So when he, she, it pronoun come in the sentence, we have to follow second structure s and es is added with the verb. Or singular noun. Singular noun, any singular noun, Mohan plays well, so Mohan is a singular, but Mohan and Ram both are the plural, so Mohan plays well, but Mohan and Ram play well, because they both are the plural noun, but Mohan only is a singular noun, so in this, we have to follow this structure. The third structure, subject plus two be verbs of present tense, am, is, are, and object. Example, he is a teacher. When we use this structure, when we want to describe the position, condition of anything and person, or want to introduce something is in present. The person, the thing, the object does not perform any action. So that's why we can support this sentence by using the am, is, are. And we show the condition and position of that object and person in present. Suppose, he is my father, he is a teacher, they are my friends. So they are, I only have introduced them, they do not perform any action. But when they perform any action in this, we have to use the verb. And we have to follow the first and second structure. Example, he is my father. So he is my father. I have introduced my father. But he does some activity. So in this, he does what? So he does what? So here he is doing some work. So that's why I have used the verb first form of the verb, and s and es is added because I have used it. He pronoun here. So this is the difference between this three structure. Now in the present tense, to ask question and give negative replies, two auxiliary verbs do and does are used. For interrogative sentence, the structure for the interrogative sentence, do and does plus subject, first form of the verb, and object, and at last we have to make question mark. For example, do you like pizza? So I have written do here, then subject I have written, then first form of the verb and pizza, and at last I have done question mark. Second one, she. If she, he, she, it and singular noun is used, so the question is used. Question is used by does. Does, then she, then play, first form of the verb, and tennis and question mark. In a negative sentence, subject plus do and does plus not plus first form of the verb and object. For example, we do not like chocolates. And if he, she, it pronoun is used, he does not go to the party. So in this way, we can make the negative sentence. I hope you got some information about the simple present tense. You just revise them, understand the rule, and try to make sentences in simple present tense. Thank you.